Hey everyone, it's Mark again. In today's video, we will create an EC2 instance in AWS Cloud, and we will use what is called AWS CLI for that. So it's a command line interface, I mean. And EC2 is simply a virtual server, but AWS calls it Elastic Compute Cloud Instance. And we previously created one. We used that AWS console. We clicked that launch instance, remember? And then we chose, for example, Ubuntu as our operating system. We did everything here in AWS console. And today we will accomplish exactly the same task, but we will use AWS CLI for that. So let's get started. So let's open the terminal first. We've got the terminal here, and we can check if we have AWS CLI installed at all. So version, I've got version 2.15.24, as you can see. And if you haven't got that installed, I will place the links to the previous videos in the comments and in the video description as well. So the very helpful command when we try to start building our commands in the CLI is help. Simply after typing something like AWS, we can always type help, press enter, and that gives us all available arguments to that command. So here we've got, as you can see, everything you can configure in AWS console, you can also configure in AWS CLI. And here we need EC2. That's exactly what we need because we want to create EC2 instance. So I can type Q to exit. I can type again AWS EC2 and I can type help again. And this will give me help or list of available arguments for AWS EC2. As you can see, it's loads and loads of them. And the one I really want, well, you know what? I will not bore you with that. I just wanted to point out that this help is really useful when you want to start building your commands. So the command I need to create EC2 instance is AWS EC2 run instances. And then I need to pass some arguments. And that's what I mean. It's very useful if you created already the EC2 instance in AWS console, because now we can scroll through those options and we can pass them as we go. You will see what I mean. So first we chose Ubuntu, yes? Ubuntu is Amazon machine image and each Amazon machine image has AMI ID. You can see it here. So I can copy that, I can pass it to my AWS CLI as image ID, and then I can just paste it. So what it says really is that our EC2 instance will have that Ubuntu as operating system. But you know what, there is one thing I want to change, because typing everything in one long line is not really, I mean, does not look really good. So what we can do, we can use the backslash, if I put backslash here and click enter, you can see a little triangle here. That means this command will be continued in new line. You will see it will look much better when we use those backslashes. So we had image ID of Ubuntu. Now I can type space, backslash, and click enter again. And we can continue again on new line. I think this way it looks clearer, better than, you know, as a one very long line. Because it would be very long, because that's not the only argument that we need. If we go back to our console, that was only first argument. First thing we decided, you know, what our server will run on. But next we had instance type and we chose T2 Micro. We chose it because it was free tier eligible. So we want the same type of instance when we create it using our AWS CLI. So we can type here instance type T2 Micro and backslash again. What else did we have here? Scroll further. We had the keeper. Remember we created one because we didn't have any. It was called what? Marek's key? Okay, we can add that as well to our command. I believe we need those quotation marks around it. And I can then use the backslash again. What else did we have? I mean, we didn't change anything in network settings. And the storage, even if it's 8 gig, that's fine. That's basically roughly what we need. What we can specify though is the region where we want that server to be created. Because remember, we've got one here. And I've got EU West 2, and this is also what we configured by default for our AWS CLI to use. But just for clarity, we can add that as well. Region EU West 2. And that's all the basic information I really need to create our server. So if I go to all of the services, if I go to EC2, you can see I have no instances running right now. If we go there, you can see no matching instances. I've got no running instances right now. But what I will do, let's take that terminal. Maybe now I will make it smaller. I will click enter and we will see in the background that it is being created. So enter And after a while, you can see it says instance ID. If I go up and refresh, well, it's still no matching instances because it's not fully running yet. But if I keep refreshing, you can see now the instance is running, but the status check is still initializing. That means this server is nearly ready for us. If I refresh again, well, still initializing, but regardless, we can see the instance ID finishes with 9360. That is indeed our instance ID. So what we have in the console and in the AWS CLI kind of matches, yes? We can see instance type is T2 Micro and key name used is Marek's key. That means I should be able, one second, let me get out of here. Maybe I will clear that. We can try to connect to that instance using this key. So I have an example here. My key was in downloads actually. So this is my key. And we will bring it up. Yeah, so this was my key, marekskey.pem. And if I run that command, if I paste that command, I should be able to log on to my server. Enter. We'll wait for a while. Oh, come on. What's going on? Let's try again. Ah, sorry. It's me being silly. If we control C that, we actually omitted one of the stages. So let me show you. If we go to security, we didn't specify the SSH port to be allowed in. This is the security group. And that's what we did when we used AWS console, but I forgot to add it here. Never mind. We can change it in edit inbound rules. We can add rule. SSH from anywhere, can save rules, but we can see now SSH is now open. So now if I go back, if I now run that command third time, well, yes, and it will let us in. DFH, that's what we also run in previous video. We can see our drive is here. It's 8 gig in size this time, but we can specify all those values and we can specify also that security group using those arguments that are made available for us. So if I do AWS EC2 run instances help, you will be able to find them all. As you can see, security groups, we've got some fancy things like kernel ID and loads of stuff. And here below, you've got exact explanation what each of them will do and how it will work. But anyways, I will just quit. And another command we can use is, for example, AWS EC2 describe instances. That will tell us a lot of information about our instance. I can use the backslash again, and I need instance ID or IDs, I think it is plural. And our ID, I mean ID of our instance, is this. I mean, it's not what I really need. If I didn't specify that, that would show us all instances available in given region. Oh, yeah, region is actually the other thing that I need. Region EU West 2. And I also need, sorry, I kind of messed it up. Maybe let me clear that. I need AWS EC2 describe instances. Now I need instance IDs, which is that. Backslash again, and region EU West 2. Now when I click enter, it will show me all information about that instance. And as you can see, it's quite a lot, because if I click space, you will see more and more information about that instance. As you can see, this is private IP address, this is public IP address, this is DNS. If I click space again, we have root device, we have security group ID, VPC used, everything. All the information that you can find here in all those tabs, you also have them available here in CLI. So it's a very long list with all possible information regarding this particular instance. And now I click Q again. You know what we can do? What we should always really do at the end, when we finish playing with our instance, we should terminate that instance. As we can see now, the instance is up and running. We'll go back to our terminal and we can type AWS EC2 terminate instances, it's also plural, and then dash dash instance IDs. Instance ID is here. I can paste it. Backslash again. Region EU West 2. And now when I click enter, this instance will be terminated. It says shutting down. So if we go here and refresh, let me remove that status. As you can see, the instance indeed is shutting down. And if I refresh it, now the public IP disappeared, but a little bit later it will be, oh, it already is terminated. So that's it. That's all I wanted to show today, and I hope that makes sense. Thank you.